welcome you all in the class of high throughput data generation and analysis. Students, today we are going to study genome duplication. What is duplication? Duplication is the making a copies. Means genes has been duplicated. Means we have the copy of the same gene. We have the multiple copy. So, in the gene, it happens during the replication. The gene is replicated, then DNA is replicated. Then we get the duplicated copy of the gene. And gene duplication play an important role in the evolution. So, Ono proposed that the whole genome duplication and polyploidization provides material for new genomes. During the 1970, there is two are hypothesis, means two rounds of polyploidization followed by gene loss and functional divergence occurred early in vertebrate lineages. What is polyploidization? That is the making of the multiple copies of the same genome. Okay, means the whole genome has been duplicated. Okay. And it provides the material for the new genome also. And sometimes in the two-hour hypothesis, it was explained that there may be the gene loss during this process. During the polyploidization, there may be the gene loss. And the functional divergence also. Okay. So, why gene duplication occur in the nature? Actually, when the gene has been duplicated, so nature always try to keep the original copy. So it always try to minimize the effect of the mutations. Whenever there is a mutations, whenever the mutations have been accumulated in the genes, then mutation always occur in the duplicated copies, and original gene remains original. Then mutation occur in the duplicated gene. So now it leads to the arisen of new genes. So gene duplication followed by sequence divergence. So sequence divergence played an important role. First of all, there is a gene duplication, then it is followed by the sequence divergence. Sequence divergence, the mutation play an important role in that. So in that way, the new gene has been arisen. So gene duplication played an important role. So only the mutation cannot create the new genes. So first of all, gene should be duplicated. We should have the duplicated copies. In the duplicated copies, there is the accumulation of the mutation, then it gives rise to the new gene. In that way, there is a structural divergence also as well as functional divergence also. Okay. Now you understood how gene duplication is important. So there are so many multiple causes behind the new gene, how the new gene arises. So the most widely used method is the gene duplication, that is followed by the mutation. Another one is the recombination. Recombination occurs, the horizontal gene transfer. So it is a rare event that the horizontal gene transfer occurs. Means the virus and bacteria, between virus and bacteria, between plants and virus and animals and virus. So it is a rare event. So in the rare event, the new gene has been arisen. So only in the few cases, 3-4%. So mutation play an important role in the new gene formation. So, but first one is important, gene duplication followed by sequence divergence. It played an important role in the formation of new gene. Synteny blocks, what are these synteny blocks? In the comparative genomic analysis, synteny blocks are equal to the regions containing the homologous genes. Means the similar genes have been accumulated at once. Okay. What are the homologous genes? that is known to similar genes. Similar gene, when we call the homologous, means it is common in different organisms. Okay, then it is said to be homologous. It is not the clustering of the genes at the same place within the same organism. If the similar genes are found within the same organism, that means that are paralogous genes. So there are two in the comparative genomics. We analyze the two types of genes, one that are orthologous or homologous genes, and another one are paralogous genes. So what are orthologous genes? Orthologous genes are same in the different organ, that is the same gene, that means like hemoglobin, globin genes or globin protein, that is same in mouse and human. So these are alpha globin are homologous. Alpha globin is homologous protein or homologous genes. Like beta globin is also homologous or orthologous genes. Okay, so that are similar in mouse and human. So same gene in different organism, we call that homologous genes or orthologous genes. Okay, and we can easily analyze these types of gene in multiple sequence alignment using sequence alignment methods, in which we can detect the syndani blocks. Okay, means using the different sequence, we can compare the different sequence or genomes, and we can detect what are the syndani blocks between the different genomes sequences. So now here they are talking about the segmental duplication in the rhabdopsin genome, means we can compare the rhabdopsin genome with the other genome also. Okay, so that are called syndani blocks. If we want to predict the homologous genes, we have to compare the rhabdopsin genome with the other genomes, other multiple genomes. Sometimes there is a presence of paralogous genes, means similar genes within the same organism. Similar genes are clustered together within the same organism. That are said to be paralogous genes. So here you can see in the Arabidopsis thaliana. Okay. So different syndani blocks are shown here. How many rounds of genome duplication? Okay. So there may be multiple rounds for the new gene formation. Two rounds of genome duplication should lead to occurrence of groups of four syndani blocks. Means the homologous genes may show the divergence. That means there may be the presence of paralogous genes. Means like alpha globin. So beta globin can be produced from the alpha globin. So in the hemoglobin, the beta is said to be driven from alpha. Okay, so you can count these within the same syndani blocks. Okay, when we compare these sequences, the genome sequences, okay, then you will find the presence of multiple genes that are similar. You can call that syndani blocks. Such tree should be then observed in the current genome. Okay, so we can analyze the old genome sequence and the current genome sequence. So there can be the presence of syndani block if the genes are similar. So they should be consistent. The almost they will have the similar sequence, only the it will vary in the few residue. So for the vertebrate solution, there is the evidence for full genome duplication. So full genome can be duplicated. That event is called polyploidization. Whole genome duplication in yeast, so there is the case. Okay, and we also have the alternation of generation within the Saccharomyces cerevisiae. There is the two types of haploids are formed, A and alpha types. Okay, and these genomes have been duplicated, they produce the diploid form, diploid generation. So in the diploid generation we have hybrid of alpha and A, A and alpha. So after the mating of the haploid, there is a diploid generation. That consists of A and alpha haplotype. Genes of A and alpha haplotypes. Actually, there is a presence of MAT locus. And MAT locus, there is a presence of different genes different cassettes like A and alpha. Sometimes A is replaced by alpha, sometimes alpha is replaced by, okay, A. So there is the alternation of generation that is found within the Saccharomyces cerevisiae. So in this figure you can see that is the common ancestor. On the upper panel you can see. Now there is the Saccharomyces lineage. So model of WGT followed by massive gene loss predict gene interleaving ancestor once after divergence from. Okay, then another organism, volatile, the Saccharomyces lineage underwent a duplication event. So, within the sister segment, there is the original gene set, but there is a copy of the gene also that has been duplicated and it is retained for the functional purpose. So, there is the exchange of the chromosomal segments, intervening genes are unrelated. So, so Cluveromyces is another species. So there is a comparison between these two. So it can show, you can see here the some of the segments are similar. Okay, it contains the similar Sentani blocks. So you can see these are the three genome sequences and it shows the comparison of three genome sequences. Now, computational approach, we use the multiple sequence alignment for the comparison of these genome sequences. And using the multiple sequence alignment, we find the Sentani blocks, find overlaps in the Sentani blocks, if these are similar or not, same. Use duplicate Sentani blocks to define sister regions in Saccharomyces cerevisiae and 145 sister regions covering 88% of the genome. Okay, so there may be the sister region that has been duplicated. So here in the figure you can see these are the genomes from the three different species of Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Related to that we have three genome sequence. Now this is the comparative figure in which we can see there is the overlapping and there is the duplicated sequence. You can see there are the homologous genes also and there are the paralogous genes also. Okay, so it is also shown by the colors, so you can compare and you can analyze. So there are the similar regions also, similar here and here. Okay, and we have one region here and here. Okay, here, okay, sometimes we do not have the presence of same, so there are the different regions which is absent in another sequence. So on the basis of color sequence and gap you can predict whenever there is a gap, this is the dissimilar sequence. Okay, some lessons from whole genome is alignment of closely related sequence. So we can do the sequence alignment of whole genome sequences, so we can retry the whole genome sequences from the NCBI database, from the genome database, and we can compare these genome sequences using the tools like FASTA. You can use for the whole genome comparison, or you can compare the single gene of like one species to the whole genome of another sequence. So FASTA Y you can use for the whole genome comparison. So in that way we can predict the paralogous genes, or you can do the self against self comparison to predict the paralogous genes. In the one gene you can compare to the whole genome. So if you want to know about the human paralogous genes of human, you can compare the one gene of human to the total whole genome sequence using the FASTA tools, FASTA variants. And in the BLAST we use for the prediction of homologous genes or orthologous genes, and FASTA we use for the prediction of paralogous genes. There is a variant of FASTA that is T-FASTA-Y. So FASTA Y we can use for the prediction of paralogous genes, and we can use it for the whole genome comparison. Okay. So practically you can retrieve the sequence, you can compare the sequence. So BLAST can be used. So it provides the output in the form of identity, sequence coverage. It uses the pairwise alignment. BLAST uses the pairwise alignment method. And there is one FASTA also uses the pairwise alignment, but it compare the variants of FASTA are available that allow us to compare the single gene to the whole genome sequences. We can compare the single gene of human with the single gene of the of organism with the whole genome of that organism for the prediction of paralogous genes. And there is a cluster W tool also. Using the cluster W uses the multiple sequence alignment method. We can align the multiple sequences at the same time and we can produce the tree, phylogenetic tree, using the multiple sequence alignment method. Using the cluster W, we can create the tree. So this tree shows the distance. So we have different nodes here. Sequences are compared with each other. First of all, one sequence is compared with the other sequence, then another second sequence is compared with all other sequences, then distance is measured, then the third one sequence is also compared with all other. So in that way, every sequence is compared to the other all sequences and a distance is calculated. Distance between each gene and similarity identity is calculated. Then the formation of distance matrix, and then we use to draw the tree. So this occur in the three step, like formation of guide tree using the pairwise alignment. Initially we select the pair of genes. When we do the comparative analysis during the sequence alignment, we find out the sum of pairs who are closely related with each other, like the two pair of sequence. So most similar sequences have been placed in the tree. So that is called binary tree or guide tree. Then this guide tree is used to put all other sequences that are left of sequences. We can add all left of sequences to this tree. So that is the third step. Okay. So these are the steps that is used in the cluster W for the formation of final phylogenetic tree. These all methods are belong to the comparative genomics. In comparative genomics, we compare all the genomes and we can find out. So today we have learned how we can predict the orthologous genes and how we can predict the paralogous genes. What are the orthologous genes and what are the paralogous genes? So alpha globin and beta globins are the examples of paralogous genes. And alpha globin of human and alpha and beta globin of and alpha globin of mouse are the example of homologous genes. And alpha globin of human and beta globin of human are example of paralogous genes. Now this lecture is over.